case picking up.
Now, which keyboard?
This line now.
After me, can you talk?
അതിൻ്റെ ഓപ്പൺ ചെയ്തിട്ട് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഏതെങ്കിലും ഒരു ഇമെയിൽ ഐഡി ഓപ്പൺ ചെയ്യാം കേട്ടോ. നീ മീറ്റിങ്ങിൽ കയറ്, എന്റെ സൗണ്ട് കിട്ടണം നോക്കി,
സൗണ്ട് കിട്ടണം
അവിടെ കിട്ടും നോക്കും. മാഡം കമ്പ്യൂട്ടറിൽ ഫോണിൽ കൊടുത്താ അല്ല, ഫോണിൽ പറ്റില്ല, അവിടെ നിന്ന് സൗണ്ട് എനിക്ക് എടുക്കാം. അതല്ല അവിടെ കാര്യമില്ല. വന്നിട്ട് പറയാൻ ടെസ്റ്റ് ചെയ്യാൻ തന്നെ നമുക്ക് സ്റ്റാർട്ട് ചെയ്യാൻ തന്നെ.
For the MAPC program of Indira Gandhi National Open University, and this is the live stream from IGNU Regional Center, Cochin. This MPCL 007 is a practical course in MA first year psychology program. It has a course title Experimental Psychology and Psychological Testing. And the overview about the psychological testing and experiments are available in the practical handbook. The soft copy of the practical handbook can be accessed from this link. Anyone who wants to download the soft copy of the practical handbook for MPCL 007 can just copy and paste this link, and it will be available in PDF format. For this session of online virtual of MPCL 007, learners up to July 2020 admission will be called for this online practical session, not by the LSE to which the learners are attached, because it is going to be hosted by one study center that is in the regional center campus. The main aim is to facilitate the course of MPCL 007 course virtually. Due to the course COVID-19 pandemic, face-to-face session is not yet made possible. So around 1,600 learners attached to both 14K Krishna Center campus, and the study online virtual session of MPCL 007. The practical online schedule is intended to be held together for both the LSE, that is LSE 14000 and when you see your registration details, you would have 14169. Whether you are attached to either of the centers, this information is very 007 is going to be through online virtual session. This practical online session schedule will be uploaded in IGNU Regional Center Cochin website. Before attending, especially if you are past the minimum completion, you need to check your validity of registration, and the registration can be checked, that is your registration details validity can be checked from IGNU website by clicking this link. I will show you how to see in the next slide also. And there is no readmission with effect from June 2020. Or not, this is your final chance if you are in the verge of completing your maximum period. How to know to check the registration details? If you click on to IGNU website, the fourth column from the left, it has the student support. In that, the first lower dialogue is the student zone, and when you go into it, the registration status is seen in the second row of the third. You will be asked to enter your enrollment number and the program, and there will be a verification course which you have to enter, and your registration details. Two lines matters a lot, that is the admission year and the admission valid up to. Admission valid up to determine of which is the last attempt you can fulfill for your term and examination in order to be declared as successfully completed. The norm for MPCL, the norm for MPCL 007, only if you as a learner have passed the internal component, you would have been allowed to appear in the external component of MPCL 007. The date of external component, that is 5OC of the practical online session of MPCL 007 will be informed later in the regional center website. If you are a learner who have already appeared and not secured 40% in the external component, that is the 5OC, and have been declared to have not successfully completed this MPCL 007, you need to appear again only for external component to secure the minimum passing mark. This information is mainly for the second attempt learners. So it's time for you to check your grade card and get back to us. So what you have, the learners have to do if MPCL 007 is not yet successfully completed. The grade card status is available in the regional center, in the IGNU main website, and you need to attend only to the external component. There is no need to repeat the internal component. So this online session of practical for MPCL 007 is not for those learners who have failed or not successfully completed in the external component of MPCL 007. Of the awards of the MPCL 007. If you as a learner have successfully completed MPCL 007, you as a learner are not eligible to attend neither this practical online virtual session for MPCL 007, that is internal component, nor the external for MPCL 007. So if your grade card shows that you have already successfully completed, this is lifetime is not for you if you are a old student. The components of the practical online virtual session MPCL 007, there are 6 activity or tests prescribed by the school of social sciences discipline of psychology, Indira Gandhi National Open University, New Delhi. Each the 2 session of 2 hours duration each. In other words, in one session, 3 tests or activity will be covered in the practical session. So what about attendance, you may ask? Attendance for all 6 activity test held in the 2 session of 2 hours duration each is compulsory. So leaving the practical online virtual session now and then may be avoided, please. And also ensure that you are physically present in front of the video during the online practical session. And be formally dressed as expected in a classroom. And what to do during the practical online session is also that you have to keep your IGNO identity card in hand while attending the online practical session of MPCL 007. And you may be aware that we have resorted to contactless admission, that is virtual online admission mode. And induction was also through the virtual mode. And there is no mandatory requirements for theory papers to be attended for the counseling session. And only and this time practical session for MPCCL 007, that is the first year, is also going to be online. So when you are called, you are away from the distance-teaching institution, you are away from the year. And also the academic counselor will be able to identify you. And please be attentive to the deliberations made. Please ask your queries without hesitation. Please limit your conversation to the practical session of MPCL 007. For queries related to any other matter other than the academic matter of MPCL 007, please send an email to rckochin@igno.ac.in. So if you are just joining us for this guideline, we are just sharing about the guidelines related to the virtual session of the first year course. And if you think you are going to miss something, will be available in IGNO Regional Center official YouTube channel, and where you can batch. The batch wise, date wise, enrollment number wise list will be uploaded at the Regional Center website. And if you enter your enrollment number, you can locate your batch and the date. Change of batch date is not permissible. Do not share the link with anyone, as it will amount. If you have to do 6 activity tests held in 2 session of 2 hours duration, each using the same link, so there won't be any separate link given. So you have to preserve that email. Just you can star it as soon as you receive that email from Regional Center email ID rckochin@igno.ac.in. The proceeding will be recorded, and the expected etiquette is that you are not supposed to be in house dress when you are assessed, because optional component is assessed. And this video is also recorded for quality purpose and also for dissemination of information to through YouTube channel after vetting. So you have to be presentable as you would do to a public. And if you are not attending the practical, what to do? That will be a question. Suppose you have already planned some action related to your job for doing this. Then you will have this question, or you will encounter inability. Online virtual session of MPCL 007. In that case, raise a representation. To include in the practical session schedule.
the next session. There won't be any supplementary session now.
Data feed. The passing mark for MCL 007 is 40%. So you have to do well in the internal component, and if you fail to secure the passing mark of 40%, the practical online virtual session of MCL 007, there won't be any supplementary examination for practical for this session. You may ask, what is the pro rata fee? This is a new term you have encountered. This is for people who are attempting the MPCL 007 practical for the second time. So the pro rata fee of ₹1,950 has to be paid by means of demand draft drawn in favor of IGNU Regional Center, payable at Cochin. Who has to pay the pro rata fee? By backlog students attending the internal component of MPCL 007 for the second time. When to pay the pro rata fee? Before attending the internal component of MPCL 007 for the second time. So friends, now if you have already in the second year, and if you have not attended the first year MPCL 007, you need to send a mail to RC Cochin, and it's preferable, because of COVID situation, we do not expect you to come face to face to attend to it. Send a mail. Anyhow, you have to post the DD and your with the cover of your certificate. And please give a mobile number which you will pick up, so that we can give you feedback. And please register for the SMS alert session also, so that you will be benefited from our communication. The activity test in practical online session have two components, that is activity and test. The tests are primarily meant to create awareness or meant for educational purpose only. So please go through the link to get a thorough understanding of the test, the test history, any frame or framework. The entire link for the test has been provided from Open Education Resource. Activity, an article link or video link related to activity has been provided to you, after which instruction will be given to complete the task. While doing activity, do not copy content verbatim from any offline or online resources, but please do write the contents in your own words. What to do before the practical online or virtual session of MPCL 007? You need to be thorough with all the six activity tests, so that you are ready to be examined by the IOC as an external component evaluation for MPCL 007. You have to administer tests on self or family members or a known person. So select the subject prior to administering the test. Please be informed that you need to document about on whom you will be administering the test. So with this I am ending, but the take home message is MPCL 007 is going to be online this time, and this examination will be counted for the June 2021 term and examination result in the grade card. And the second message is, suppose you have missed out on the first year practicals last year and you are in the second year, you need to pay the pro rata fee and request the regional center Cochin to add your name for the practical session. The third is, suppose you have crossed even the second year and you are between the minimum and the maximum period, please remember that facility you cannot avail of, and you have to resort to a payment of pro rata fee if you have not attended MPCL 007, or if you have not yet successfully completed MPCL 007. With this, now I am going to request Dr. Jaichandran. He is our empaneled academic counselor for MAPC program in Regional Center Cochin. He will be sharing about the activity test, followed by another two academic counselors, who Madam Mercy Thomas and Dr. Larima. And finally, we are also listening to Dr. A.K. Prema, the coordinator for Modern Study Center 14350, situated in Regional Center campus, about on what to do related to the record work after the completion of the activity. So I will suggest, now when you are listening to it, you will be so much anxious about so many things. I will suggest, please take one day at a time, and it is going to be only one day, two sessions in a day. So it will be comfortable for you. Please make yourself comfortable rather. Take one day at a time, and please keep your friends, your official associates informed about your commitment, so that there will be easy way made for you to successfully attend this MPCL online session and successfully complete it also. And the take home message will be that take one day at a time. That is the life skill which I will tell you, without worrying about tomorrow. Over to Dr. Jayachandran, please.
Thank you, ma'am. I'm trying, not able to press the window soon.
Sir, or you want to, we have given permission to share, sir. Suppose you are unable to upload it from your end, you can send it to rckochin@ignu.ac.in. We will upload it from here, sir.
Okay, okay.
We are in front of the machine only, double okay. Machines. Yes. Friends, still sir is talking, I mean preparing himself to send the slide. We just want to share certain information once again, so that it will be a recap for those who have joined in late. This practical MAPC CL001 is the first year practical course in the MA psychology program, with the title Experimental Psychology and Psychological Testings. The other theory papers, MPC 1, 3 and 4, have already been uploaded. The YouTube videos have been uploaded in IGNU Regional Center YouTube channel. So you can be benefited by seeing those videos. Otherwise also, if you download the study materials, or if you ask for soft copy of the materials, you can download it and you can see related terms used in the test and activity from those study material and be benefited also. And in addition, I also want to share, friends, that the guides which we have prepared, an SMS with sharing the link where we have uploaded. We are yet to receive the PowerPoint from Dr. Jayachandran. So I just share one more thing related to our admission. Actually, currently our admission is open. And you are welcome to join certain certificate program. Many a time, people of psychology background, they take certificate in disaster management, certificate in human rights, which are more related to the concepts which they have learnt in the theory and put back to open, and you are welcome to join us also for. If you are in the verge of completion the second year, so this session will be useful for you to know. And the guidelines and for admissions are getting access through the
Hello ma'am.
Yes ma'am. Yes sir, we are listening.
Can I present now?
You have got it yourself? Okay.
Yes, yes.
Yes, yes.
So, let me begin.
Yes, so over to Dr. Jayachandran, speaking to MAPCL practical guidelines. Sir will be talking about the test school of social sciences, discipline of psychology has listed 6 activity tests so to be carried out in 2 hours duration for 2 sessions. Over to Dr. Jayachandran.
Is it visible to you now? Is it visible to you now?
Yes, yes sir, yes sir. Okay. We have muted all mics, so
okay. I just want to, but you may not be able to see me, so I'm trying for.
No sir, we can see sir.
You can see me?
No, not you. Okay. When the screen is shared, I don't think it will be coming.
Because then I can, without my photo, I think I can proceed. Okay.
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
I am asked to do 2 out of 6. 2 I will be presenting. So it consists of, and it is not fair for me to take that much time now. First is that, what is the IGNO link and guideline? You are supposed to draw a Gardner's plot based on the intelligence theory. So when I am teaching you, the thing is, not any faculty, you must be able to, you must be clear that I also should not, or the faculty should not influence you when you try to do the actual practical, because from the practical you have to get the result. So ability to adapt is one of the But for that, you must know what exactly is intelligence and the various other theories. I will be sharing all these things to you on MA by CA is 100. That means the mental age that you will be getting from a test. And the actual chronological standard is 50. All these things actually you are supposed that any quality that also will be covering to you. We'll be sharing the actual history later. So the important question is that whether all the intelligent people, so far all the intelligent people are successful in life. For example, borderline is 70, and the superior intelligence and the blessed people are in our in the village, common, very common people, even without much education, runs the life show successfully. But many highly intelligent, so called intelligent, so-called officials, they may run away from the life when a problem is faced by them. So all these concepts are there. I'm just showing the slides one by one, and I'll be skipping few because all these things cannot be discussed for one of time. Now you just see the next very important secondary view on intelligence. That is ability to adjust to any new situation. I mean, for example, COVID is a new situation. And then they never, this generation never thought of this. So ability to solve any new problem and the ability to understand any idea. What happens to us, though the years are want listen to? We want listen to what others say. So if you say,
no, sorry to interrupt, sir. You have to move your slides, sir.
Okay. Easily understand USA. So the multiple intelligence theory, intelligences, all this you can see now, and just the interpersonal intelligence, intrapersonal, naturalistic, then comes the Sternberg's intelligence theory, because Sternberg's, you see, Lord, actually you have to work on it. And here you just see the next slide alone, that is this particular slide. Sternberg clearly said, this is hypothesis, the internal world of information processing, experience and past learning. And this is the most important question that is given to you. The
first slide, let me go to second slide.
It is moving here.
Sir, that is sir, share it in the title window. Sir, share it in the F5 plus the window.
Thanks for the help of my daughter. She let me help me. There, we'll move you. Now which screen you are seeing? Hello?
No, no PowerPoint screen is visible.
Can you
view? You can send to ask the question at ignu.ac.in.
Okay, I have actually sent this to this particular, MMMs, that we have made a group, and that I have put it. If somebody can do it easily, then...
Yes, yes, we will do it.
It is there, in the ignu practical group, I have put it.
Okay.
If you are able to see my slides, please support. We are trying from here.
Definitely, sir. Now, yes, we can see your slide.
Okay. This is the particular, okay. Whatever thought it goes. So, this is a particular thing Sternberg said, that is the third one. The external world of adapting to shaping and selecting real world environments. So in this particular case, you have to understand that. I think you are able to see this slides now, removing slides. Now you are able to see
yes,
the...
Yes, sir.
Okay.
We can
see. Okay, since I have put all this effort. So this is the thing I was discussing, even the borderline IQ with 70 also, people are successful. Whereas the 120 superior intelligence fail into life. So this is the importance of intelligence. You cannot say that just because of an IQ test of party or something, the person is very intelligent, they will be successful. It is not necessary. So, another thing is that the ability to adjust any new situation, solve and understand. USA is the best, you can, short form that you can use, remember. So, multiple intelligence theory, see all these nine intelligences are also mentioned here, verbal, linguistic, logistic, all this will be sharing, you can learn later, and also it's a part and parcel of your cognitive psychology, visual, spatial, musical intelligence, interpersonal intelligence, intrapersonal, naturalistic intelligence. Then comes a standard theory of intelligence. Here you see the third one, he has clearly mentioned the three points that he has mentioned, the internal world of information processing, experience of and past learning. Then comes the external world of adapting. This is the most important thing that the students have to work on. And the COVID-19 is mentioned here because it's very simple in a nutshell. That is, whatever you say, many intelligent people, maybe even the US president, ignored using a mask. See, the question is that person, whether such a behavior is intelligent or not. Actually, you are supposed to adhere to the government instructions, whatever be the conditions. And yeah, it is very sure that those who really took all care never got affected with COVID. And also, even when the COVID symptoms are there, they are supposed to report. All this, and not only because studying from the community and spoiling the entire nation sometimes. So the adapting is a very, very important thing, whether it's personal life or the social life. So I'm just passing this because this is an important slide for all that. And for the convenience of the students, I'm just showing this. This will be shared to you later. Now comes the next important thing is that the halo effect. The halo effect also, the ignore link is like this. Four things you have to do. First, you have to study what is halo effect, which I have a. The key takeaways from the main experiment, the halo effect, because it is a journal. That journal is discussing about various halo effects. So based on that, you are supposed to answer. But I'm sure it will be very, because all of our faculty, including the coordinator, Pranam ma'am, is that, and we also found it very difficult for you to understand easily. So I this particular journal that I'm going to just discuss to you for you to do the practice. So the definition of halo effect, again here the Thorndike is the person in 1920, he made all these things. So let me see the halo effect definition, also known as the physical attractiveness of stereotype. And this is called, in the coming slides you will come to know, this is actually a cognitive bias. Actually, we are all intelligent. We all think and take decisions, but this halo effect influences people when judging any situation, any person or so. So that is why I am repeating, also known as the physical attractiveness stereotype. And what is beautiful is good is a principle that we adopt, whatever be the thought we apply. So based on this, the history of halo effect is based on the done by Thorndike and all that. He is, it was in 1920 that character without having spoken to subordinate. But the result was on seeing handsome, very attractive, tall people, they gave the best marks on intelligence and all that. Actually, that can never be true. So just going through the study, the studies are again repeatedly said, many studies, all this will be shared. Due to lack of time, I'm just showing only we have influences our evaluation specific traits. For example, so if we have good traits also, the individual has got on a particular trait, there is a chance that another person. For example, several different studies have found that. That when we write people as good looking, we also tend to believe that they have positive personality traits. Those are good looking because we all want to be smart. So when we see smart people, we see that they are good in their behavior, intelligence, etc. Then it's a double-edged sword also, because the people, if you are studying the trait theory, you will come to know that. Based on their trait also. So it's a double-edged sword also. Some people, suppose I believe, I have a trait to believe that, that is evolved by me, that the good-looking people are cheating, they are dishonest, then that also may come into take place. Anyhow, when you do research and all that, it's very, very important. It's not a job that you have to study this halo effect, because when you study research and all that, that you may be misled. If the halo effect in the CBT, cognitive behavioral theory that you will be studying in the second year, of course, if you go through this, you will come to know about a condition called ASOMPA, that is absolutism, magnification, minimization. Likewise, a lot of the six things are there. Likewise, the halo effect is also a cognitive bias. This misleads you, that is the most important thing. And the observations are based on his study. Now the particular thing that you are asked to do is that the experiment grade, because this is the particular thing I'm telling, it's very difficult for you to understand. So I have briefed in some 10 slides, that also you can slowly study. Actually, few students, about 118 students of Michigan University took part in the experiment. One thing they did is that they gave a pre-recorded video about a professor, and later these students were split into two, and this Belgian professor was asked to do two conditions. That is, one is to behave warmly, one is to behave coldly. So it actually, those who had strong attributes about the professor, the original professor, did not allow to play a cognitive bias. Otherwise, it affected. But in any case, the personality, the belief about a person actually stronghold. This is what is meant by this particular study. When you go through this also, then it will be very easy for you to do this practical. And based on that, I'm just going back, based on that, you are supposed to answer in your own words, that is, repeat the takeaways from the main experiment, what you understood, how hollow effect being used for one's advantage, find the application and common uses of hollow effect. Is there any relationship between learned behavior and hollow effect? Because you already, I told you, learned behavior. For example, I believe that the good-looking people are bad, actually. They are not intelligent, they are cheating. So that also may affect. All this, why I am not explaining much more is that the conclusion should not affect the students when they are doing the practical. Hope you have got some idea about this. We'll be coming to you, according to the instructions received, we'll be coming to you for another 4 hours to explain all the practicals by each faculty. So that's very good. Thank you. Madam? Ma'am?
Thank you very much, sir. You are listening to Dr. Jayachandran. Now, Dr. Mercy Thomas will be taking over. Over to
yes, hello, ma'am. Good evening to all. Then I will return to the format for practice. A locus of controller, then for old age, and then interview to another.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
കഴിഞ്ഞ ഇംഗ്ലീഷിലെ പറയാനായിട്ട്
This heading will contain the title or name of the practical. First, this one is the internal and external control. First, practical name, then. Next, aim of the practical. Aim of the practical is to assess the personality orientation of the subject with reference to internal and external locus of control. Next one, introduction. Then introduction includes internal and external control of locus of control. Then explain internal locus of control. Then external locus of control. Then after that, powerful and of the
internal. Excuse me, ma'am. Your screen is coming in two sides, ma'am, and no PowerPoint is coming, ma'am.
No, PowerPoint is not there, ma'am. I'm just explaining only.
Okay. But your screen, I think it is in multiple location, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Madam, then, stop sharing, click it away.
In the last end?
Stop sharing, blue button, blue color.
Then next one is materials required for this locus of control inventory, then answer sheet, then writing materials. Next step, description of the material, internal and external locus of control inventory developed by, then explain about this 29 items is there. Then out of this 29 questions, we have to assess only 23 items. Then 29 pairs of statements are there, 23 which are scored. Then each alternative is believed to be either internal or external locus of control. Then scoring is that, before that we have procedure, see the participant comfortably and establish a good rapport with the participant. Then say them to Rotter's locus of control is a self-administrating test and can be administered individually or groups. The scale is presented before the participant and give the following instructions. This test contains 29 items and each item have two options, A and B. You are expected to read choice carefully in every item. You have to mark tick or circle either A or B. The test generally takes 20 or 30 minutes, but there is no definite time limit. Then there must be three questions. The environment should be provided for the participant, then it should be ensured the participant does not omit any questions. Then after that scoring, then discussion, after conclusion, then a reference should be write on only on APA format. Then question will be given to you. Then next one is, interview with an older adult, the second one. Second one, rapport building, you should have a social smile with them. Then you have to ask personal details about them, for that name, address, then contact number, male or female, age, marital status, then occupation, then main headings for that. Health problems, if you have any eye problem, vision, glaucoma, then diabetes, like that. Next one is hearing loss. Then third one, decrease in strength, stamina. That means weight loss, heart rate, chest pain, nausea, dizziness. Then any breath problem, anemia, or low level of oxygen carrying. That means red blood cells, fatigue, then iron supplements, allele medication, then high or low BP problem, if any memory loss problem, Alzheimer's problem, then continuing this, if they have any psychological issues, then you have to draw family tree or genogram. This is the two experiments given to me to explain. Okay.
Asi ma'am.
Yes.
Next person who is going to explain the two more experiments, that is Ms. Singlarmina ma'am.
Thank you, Prama ma'am. Thank you, Asi Kushin, for inviting me for the session. So, for the practical, for the first time online practical, I know our students, our learners will be more curious and they'll be more confused with the things. There is no need of confusion. We are ready for every doubts, clearance, everything will be sorted out. No need of worries. So, we have got, we have got six practical sessions. And the first one is, now, first one is based on a Bobo Dole experiment. It is based on the theory, social learning theory. And it was put forward by Albert Bandura. And what the students, you have to do is, you have to visit the link that is given in your guidelines. And the link is about Bobo Dole experiment, which was conducted by Albert Bandura in 1961. So you have to watch the video and you have to answer the questions, the difference between social learning theory and social cognitive theory. That is the first assignment. Then application of social learning theory. That's the second one. And based on the theory and its application, do you think the violence is contagious? That is the first experiment that you have to do. And I'll present the format which you have to follow for writing the report. So usually we used to say as the record, but this time the IGNO report of about 15 to 20 pages. So each test should be written in 4 to 5 pages. So I'll just present. I think I'm audible, right? Hello?
Ma'am, you are audible, ma'am.
Yeah, okay. Thank you. So Bobo doll experiment, for the students I'm saying, you have to write introduction about the experiment. So you have to write, as you are doing the experiment, like social learning theory and social cognitive theory, so you have to write what is learning, what are the types of learning, observational learning, and learning in social context, that is social learning, in which the observation serves a major part. And so, and you have to mention about Albert Bandura and the study and the test, that is Bobo doll experiment, you have to mention in one or two sentences. Then you have to write aim of the test. So it is to understand the purpose of social learning theory, social learning through observation and imitation. I think my slides can be seen, right? It's not slide, I'm sorry, it's the Word document.
No, ma'am, we could not see, ma'am.
Oh, okay.
ഇപ്പൊ
ഇൻട്രൊഡക്ഷൻ അബൌട്ട് ദ എക്സ്പെരിമെന്റ് ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ബോബോ ഡോൾ എക്സ്പെരിമെന്റ് സോ വാട്ട് ഇസ് ലേണിംഗ് ടൈപ്സ് ഓഫ് ലേണിംഗ് എവറിഥിങ് യു ഹാവ് ടു റൈറ്റ് ആൻഡ് ദ എയിം ഓഫ് ദ സ്റ്റഡി ദെൻ ദ പർപ്പസ് ഓഫ് ദ ടെസ്റ്റ് വാട്ട് ഇസ് ദ പർപ്പസ് ഓഫ് ദിസ് ടെസ്റ്റ് ഈസ് ടു ബി ആൻഡ് യു ഹാവ് ടു റൈറ്റ് ദീസ് ത്രീ these three questions, difference between social law.
Yeah, that we can do in our sessions, ma'am. No,
yeah,
problem.
Yeah, that will be better.
We have developed all the six
questions. I'll try to speak for the students to catch up. No problem.
Okay, Glavina, you can continue.
Yeah, okay. Thank you. So, assessment of 16 personality factors, that is our fifth test. So in the test, in the guideline, you can see a link of
the test testing here. So it is not traditional testing here.
No problem.
Your screen is not visible.
Yeah. Okay.
Totally blank.
I'll look up.
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you. So you have to write introduction regarding the personality factors. Then our specific aim for the test is to measure the relative strength of 16 personality factors of the participant. Then you have to write the method. Under that, you have to write participants' profile, their name, age, gender, education, qualification. Then experimenters' profile. So in this test, you have to. You have to have a participant for this test to do to measure the 16 personality factors. So in the 16 personality factors, in this case we are measuring the source traits, 16 source traits. I think you have learned in your test year that there are source traits and source traits. I'm not going much to that portion. All these things we can discuss in our session. So
So our material is not usual 16-tier cluster. Instead, in the guideline, they are giving another test. It is called a 16 preliminary IP-IP scale. So in this online test, you have to click that link and you have to follow the instructions that is coming in this link. So description of the test you have to write. And the procedure, the participant should be seated comfortably and establish a good rapport. The experiment should read out the instructions for the participant. That is coming under this link, and there is no time limit, but it is good to remind the participant not to delay. Instead, give immediate answers and move along. So in this personality test, there will be 164 statements. Usual 16-tier questionnaire will have 187 statements. So I told you that there are some slight changes in this 16-tier questionnaire, which is available in online format. So you have to indicate how accurate it is on the scale, like disagree, slightly disagree, neither agree or not disagree, slightly agree and agree. So it is a 5-point scale, and the participant should mark which one is more accurate or appropriate for them. And before this, before starting the session, you have to get a consent from the participant, and the scoring and interpretation, all those things are done through the online itself, and the relative strength of each personality factor can be retrieved after the completion of the test. I think some of you might have tried this test. So you can see after completion of the test, the score of each of the traits will be mentioned, and based on that scores, you have to interpret the basic personality traits of the person. And the precaution should be you should give a congenial environment, and the participant should not omit any item. And the result can be seen as scores between 0 and 4. Usually it will be a 10 score, that is the minimum score for each trait is 0 and the maximum score is 10. But in this online test, you can see that the lowest score will be 0 and the highest score will be 4. And the table should be drawn in the left side of the sheet. And for the discussion, for every practical session which include scales or rating scales or questionnaires, you have to write the discussion. Last time I mentioned about Bobo Doll. In that, there is no need of discussion. Instead, you have to write three answers for 3 points. So, in this case, you have to write discussion. For discussion, there should be 3 paragraphs. So, the first paragraph should be gay with immediate answers. The second paragraph is meant for discussing each person's attacking score and then the interpretation. And the final paragraph should indicate the most and the least scores of the rate and mention the critical person as well as the concept. Uniformity of the report also. Okay, so these are the two practicals which I need to discuss. So first one was Bobo Doll experiment, and the second one was Cattle 16-tier, and the last one, the sixth experiment was to read a journal about the halo effect. So you have to read the halo effect experiment and done by Nisbet and Wilson, and based on that journal you have to write the answers for the 4 questions. These are the 6 practical sessions which you have to complete for this MPCL 007. Okay, so thank you ma'am for giving me the opportunity to explain about these 2 practicals, and also to give an outline of the 6 practical sessions. Thank you. Ask the question.
Thank you.
Yeah.
My
comments. You were so far listening to what are the modalities, norms, and what are the default actions you have to take by like checking your registration details for attending the practical session of MACL 001, which is the first year subject of MA Psychology program. Now over to Dr. A.K. Prema, coordinator, IGNU Model Study Center in IGNU Regional Center campus, to know what to do after attending the practical online session of MPCL 001. Friends, if you have just logged in to this live stream, don't worry, the PowerPoints, everything will be available, including a PDF format of the guidelines. This is whatever we have deliberated, we have listed it out. And if you have any queries beyond this, you need to write to rcquestion@ignu.ac.in. Over to Dr. A.K. Prema, coordinator, IGNU Model Study Center, 14000, situated in IGNU Regional Center Campus, Cochin.
Good evening to all, respected regional director, then my dear friends who are the academic counselors, and my dear learners. Okay, now we know we have already completed all the six experiments, I think. And after completing the six experiments, what you have to do? That is what I am going to speak. Is a record should be prepared and how to submit that and what would be the content like that, okay? Now, after the practical session, that is internal component of MPCL 007, you are expected to prepare a document or a record which has to be handwritten, okay? The record work should be of approximately 15 to 20 pages, excluding the picture, graph, tables, and other personal comments, etc., on the activity or the test done by done in both the sessions. Now, the written record for MPCL 007 needs to be sent either by CSP post or submitted in person, that is by hand, at the regional center after a few days of practical, the conduction of the practicals. That we will give the date by which you have to send the record to regional center. And it is preferably, I don't advise you to send by courier because there is some chance for losing the material when you send in the courier. Please write on the top of the envelope MPCL 007. When you post it on the cover, you can write MPCL 007. It is also advised to keep the photocopy of the record work for your reference later, as the original document will not be returned back after evaluation. So for internal assessment, we have to evaluate, or the academic counselor has to evaluate the record, and that will not be returned to you. That is why you are supposed to keep a copy for reference, and including the Viva Voce examinations. Now, if you are submitting in person, you will be asked to drop in the drop box after entering in the register in the regional center. Okay, the regional center, one box will be kept, and you can register the your enrollment number, name, etc., and you can drop the record in that particular box that is kept. Keeping the SOP for COVID-19, your record will be manually touched only after 3 days. Hence, kindly send the records by speed post. It is preferable, and you can bring it directly, and you can bring keep in the drop box. If you are If you are submitting in person, you will be asked to drop in the drop box after entering. Next. If you are attending for the first time, please write all the details which are given. That is your enrollment number, your contact details, including the phone number, then affix a photocopy of student ID card in written document, enclose the print screenshot of the batch. So you can take a screenshot and that also can be kept in the record. Igno ID card copy and also registration details. Now, if you are attempting for the second time, second or further time, you can include all these items, six items, plus the grade card. All the items are same, plus the grade card copy also you have to. Now, how to write record work after attending the practical online session? Start writing the record only after attending both the sessions and six activity or test. You cannot submit the record after doing one experiment like that, because we will be taking the attendance also, and I told you attendance is mandatory for practical sessions. So complete all the six activities and after that only you start writing the record. As per your convenience, you can either buy your record book from a stationery shop or use A4 size loose sheets to write the document after attending the two practical sessions. So A4 size paper you can use, loose sheets, even if you want to change one page that can be done. So, or you can buy a practical notebook from the stationery shop. Now, how to write record work after attending the practical online session? The advantage of loose sheet is that the errors can be easily replaced. But while binding the document, loose sheet should be double checked for correctness of sequence of page number. Hence, it is suggested that you keep numbering the pages as you are writing the document. So here you can understand one thing, because usually we sign the academic counselor signs the ref records. So all corrections will be done in the ref record, and all the, including the corrections, you can write the final record. So there won't be the chance of some correction or mistakes in the fair record. But here it is not like that. You are directly submitting the fair record to the regional center. So you should be very careful in putting the numbers and arranging the sheets in the correct order. Okay. Now, how to write record work after attending the practical online sessions? Please do not write the record or document before attending both the sessions and the six activities. That is already mentioned. To complete all the six activities, then only you can write the record or the document. Now, what all the pages are to be kept in front? The format will be, that is already explained by Gramina Madam and Mercy Madam. So the format is given in the practicum record, that is page number 9 and 10 in the section 4 of the handbook. Okay, that can be either you can download it, or all of you might have received the handbook for practicum writing. Now the same pattern may be followed, that is the format should be same for most of the experiments, but there should be some change with regard to the type of the experiment that you do. For example, results and interpretation may not be there for some experiments. So at the end of the writing, you have to give the references in the API format also for each experiment. Now, how to write record work after attending the practical online session? Same thing, we are continuing. Separate section on reference written in API format after writing each of the activity of the test should be there at the end of the writing. Okay, that is some mistake there. That's okay. Now that I have already explained, at the end of each activity or the test, there should be the references in the API format. Now, what should we, what should the document record have? Okay. What are the content? What should be the pages? What should be the contents of the record? The document or the record should have a title page, of course, the first page, there should be a cover page, of course, and there should be title page and the sample of which will be given here. Then the table of contents, or the name of all the six activities, mention the page number also, corresponding page number also should be put. Now the document or the record should have the page number 25, that is appendix 1 and appendix 2 of the practicum handbook, PCL 007, as the first two pages. So first you have to attach or enclose appendix 1, and after the title page only, after the title page you have to keep the appendix 1, after that appendix 2, as the first two pages. This is actually the cover page, okay? This should be the cover page. Next to is appendix 1, where you give all the details of the student and also the signature of the learner, etc. And this original sender are under which, okay? Title page of the document or the record. This is the page number 26, that is the title. Okay. The page, page number 26, that is appendix 2, where the academic counselor has to put the signature. Okay, your signature, all the details, and your signature should be there, and academic counselor also should put her signature in the same page. Now, acknowledgement page of the document or record, the page number 27 or appendix 3 in the manual or in the handbook is only an acknowledgement and need not be affixed, as it is online session held for both LSE 14000 and 14169. There are two study centers, okay. Now, we are conducting the activities for both the study centers together or combined form. So you need not keep the appendix 3, copy of the appendix 3. The speed post number if sent by post, or the register entry number if dropped in the drop box, will be the acknowledgement number from the regional center. Okay. The acknowledgement, that is a page actually. That is appendix 3, which is also given here. Now, since MPCL 007 has been held jointly for both LSEs, I have already told you, that is for 14000 and LSE 14169, which is Dhananaya, there is no need to get the signature of the coordinator of the of either of the LSE in the record. But in the conventional system, we used to get the signature of the coordinator from the respective LSEs, but here it is a combined form, so the coordinator need not put the signature. That is why that acknowledgement has no much relevance this time. Plagiarism check will be made within a batch and across the batches for the record. Okay, you should be very careful to avoid all the plagiarism, so that you need not copy exactly from your peer or from some other book. Hence, please do not copy from your peer. Now, what is the internal evaluation component of MPCL 007? The internal evaluation component comes about 50% of the total marks. So they have to consider, the academic counselor or the examiner has to consider all these things. So, the record work and your interaction in the online or virtual practical session will be assessed by academic counselor to contribute to the internal evaluation component of MPCL 007. So they will observe, it's actually the observation of the academic counselor, and they can read all these things. Okay. The appearance of the document also matters while presenting to the external evaluator. Now, hence, please write legibly, the record book to be legibly written, okay? The internal evaluator will not be present during the external VIVA-OC evaluation component session. But in the real mode, in the offline mode, the internal examiner also will be there. But in the online mode, the VIVA-OC internal examiner will be there, only the external examiner will be there. Hence, your record should be complete and self-defending to prove its value. It is reiterated that the record should have page number 25, that is appendix 1, appendix 26, and appendix 2 of the practical handbook of PCS-07, as the first two pages of your written and document record and record should be. Now, the features as a system, feature as a system, your attendance will be considered for internal marks. No, those who have below 80% attendance will not be allowed to sit for the external examination. So they will not be eligible to attend the external examination. This is what you will see. And your understanding of the matter, your interaction with the academic counselor, the written document wherein you are organized and presented the content based on the practical session, that means your way of presentation, how organized the contents are, like that. The overall understanding of the activity or the test as reflected in the report. Okay, these are things you should be careful with when you write the record. And I think I have already covered almost all the doubts. Any further doubt is there, we can you can ask the regional center, you can send the email to the regional center, or you can give your queries in the WhatsApp group, but it is already made. And not for the first year, so we haven't formed the WhatsApp group. For the other 2 years, then. 19 admission, July 19 admission and 20 January admission, they have a very active WhatsApp group. So you can give your queries in the WhatsApp group. As far as possible, we will try to answer all your queries. Thank you. Thanks a lot once again. Okay.
Friends, you are listening to the live stream on guidelines related to the MPCL 007. Of the MA in Psychology of Indira Gandhi National Open University. The live stream was hosted by IGNU Regional Center Kochi. The recording of this video will be available in the official YouTube channel of Regional Center Kochi. Thank you.